When a star runs out of fuel after millions and billions of years, it explodes into a supernova. And depending on its size, it can turn into a white dwarf, a black hole, or a neutron star. Neutron stars are very dense. Imagine a star of millions and millions of miles compressed into an object of about 20 miles. The electrons and protons at such high gravity combine to form neutrons. So neutron stars are very dense. They are so dense that 1 teaspoon of neutron star weighs about 1 billion tons, or equivalent to that of entire Mount Everest. So what would happen if you can bring 1 teaspoon of neutron star to Earth? Hey everyone, this is TyroScience, simplified science to make you smarter. So first, let's see the difficulty in obtaining 1 teaspoon of neutron star. Any object or ship that comes near the neutron star will be ripped apart. Because remember, the gravity of neutron star is extremely high. Well, suppose you were able to solve this problem somehow. Then you have to find a way to land your probe on the surface. Neutron stars rotate thousands of times in 1 second, and they emit magnetic waves 10 million times stronger than that of Earth. Well, again, let us assume that you somehow solve the problem of rotation and magnetic fields. Then you have to face the defense system of a neutron star, the pulsars. The next problem will be the landing, because the surface temperature is in millions of degrees. And yes, the gravity is 200 billion times that of Earth. If you compare that with Sun, it is 6,000 degrees and 27 times the gravity of Earth. So you can imagine. You know what? Let's just say you were able to solve all these problems and were able to extract 1 teaspoon of neutron star, which I'll say again, weighs 1 billion tons. Then you have to somehow figure out a way to transport it directly to Earth, because 1 teaspoon of neutron star do not like traveling. I'll come back to it. Okay, so it's on the Earth and you know how to hold it, because remember, 1 billion tons. So will it affect the rotation of the Earth? Not really. But here is where things get explosive. So neutron stars are held together by something called degenerative pressure, generated by insane gravity of neutron stars. And well, you removed all that gravity. Now neutrons want to decay back to electrons and protons. And that process will produce energy according to the famous E equals mc squared. That will be equal to 50 trillion atom bombs. Let's just say it won't be good, and the whole process is not a great idea. Please hit the subscribe button if you want to see more videos like this. Don't forget to like, comment, and share. And as always, keep learning, keep exploring until you know everything.